Hi, we are solving CAT 2019 slot 1 paper, part 1, con section. We are taking few questions, 5 questions and trying to solve. Basically looking at approaches of how to solve in the CAT examination. We look at this sum. So, two cars travel same distance starting at 10 a.m. and 11 a.m. and they reach a common destination at the same point of time. The first car travels for at least 6 hours. So if it travels for 6 hours, that means second car must have traveled for 1 hour less. So automatically 5 to 6, we want the highest possible value of percentage increase. You can make out 20%. You can straight away mark the answer. If you're not sure, because they said at least 6 and you want to still be confirmed, you can take a higher value, 7 and 6. You can make out 6 to 7 is 16.66%. You should know 1/6. Now the increase out here is 1 out of 6. 1 out of 6 you should know is 16.66%. You can see the percentage is decreasing and we want the highest possible percentage. So 20% is highest, straight away is the answer. So normally in such cases, when you have the extreme case, like highest possible, is the extreme case that will be the answer. So at least 6 hours, you can directly take it as 6 and 5 and get the answer. It doesn't take any time to solve the sum. Just the time to read the sum is what is the time to mark the answer. Just understand and try to solve things orally, you'll be able to do it fast in a lot of cases. Okay, this sum does look tough, but it said R in AP. So I can take A1, A2 as 1, 1, 1, 1. Even 1, 1 is an AP. And they've said sum till AN. Let me take N equal to 1 also. So I'll get last term as root of A1 plus root of A2. It is the last term, which is same as first term. So first term is same as last term. That means there is only one term in the series. If I put n equal to 1. Now I've taken all as 1, 1. So root of 1 plus root of 1, that will be 1 upon 2. Now substitute. I've taken n equal to 1. So this becomes 1 upon 1 plus 1, which is half. It satisfies. This numerator becomes 0. Not possible. Here also numerator becomes 0. Not possible. Here numerator becomes 1, but denominator becomes 0. Again, not possible. You can directly make out the answer is A. And that's the difference between being good at max and cracking the CAT. A person who is good at max will try to solve this sum, which will eventually take a longer time. But what is required in the CAT is simple techniques that you can solve and try to get things fast. So if you can use the techniques, I'm sure you'll be able to solve things fast. Next. AB is the diameter of radius 5. In geometry, normally prefer drawing, okay, because that gives a better picture and reduces the mistakes. PQ are 2 points in a circle, so that PB is 6. So let me put PB as 6. And length AP, so AP is twice of AQ, so AQ will be from here. So whenever you have a diameter, diameter subtends a right angle at any point on the circle. So I know this is a right angle. And moment you see 6 and 10, you can make out that this is 8. You should know triplets, the basic triplets, 4 triplets, 3, 4, 5, 5, 12, 13, 7, 24, 25, and 8, 15, 17. These are triplets you should know. So moment you see 6 and 10, you can make out the third side is 8. If this is 8, that means AQ will be 4. They mentioned AQ is half of AP. Now you can use this right angle triangle. So we want QB, BQ. PQ is square root of 100 minus 16 by Pythagoras theorem, root of 84. If you want, you can check root of 84 in a calci because you have a calci in the exam, you'll get 9.1. Anyway, it's more than 81, so 8.5 and 7.8 is ruled out. You're left with 9.3 and 9.1. Another way of approximation is, it is 9 definitely, 3 more than 81. 3, and this is between 9 and 10, so you can say 9 plus 10. This is the approximate value. It comes to 9.15 approximately. So you can make out close to 9.1. This is the approximate way of calculating square root. But again, CAT doesn't expect you to, you know, mug up tables or mug up square roots. The moment you have this, you can use a calci if you want, if you don't know this particular technique. That's fine. 5.55 raised to x. So if I take 5.55 raised to x is 1000. So I know 5, I'm approximate to 5 now. 5 raised to 4 is 625. 5 square is 25. स्क्वायर ऑफ डेट इज 625, तो 5:4 625, 5:5 विल गो टू बिगर देन डेट 3125, विच मीन्स आई नो एक्स इज बिटवीन 4 एंड 5, से 4 पॉइंट समथिंग स्मॉल वैल्यू बिकॉज इज एक्चुअली 5.5 है, वेरी क्लोज टू 4, सो 4 पॉइंट सम स्मॉल वैल्यू. कमिंग टू नेक्स्ट 0.555 raised to y, लेट मी टेक दिस 0.5 विच विल कम टू हाफ रेज टू y, राइट, और यू कैन से 2 raised to -y इक्वल टू 1000. नाउ आई नो 2 raised to 10 इज 1024. Right, 2 raised to 10 is 1024. That means y will be -10. Approx again. This is all approximation values. So I can substitute out here. So 1/4 - 1/-10 is approximately 1/4 + 1/10. Now both are very small values, so automatically 3 and 1 is ruled out. 2/3 also will not be possible because 1/4 is 0.25, 1/10 is 0.1. It will come to approximately 0.35, which will come to 1/3. You'll get the answer. So again, if you're a mathematician, I'll try to solve this. You don't require to solve this. You just need to approximate, you'll get the answer. Though the answer looks close, but actually it is quite far. Even if you do a small error to 4 to 5 or 5, 10 or 9, you'll still get this answer. Your answer will never come to 2/3. So approximation is also things that you can do to get things, get solve things fast in the CAT exam. The income of Amla is 20% more than that of Bimla and 20% less than that of Kamla. So now let me take, you can either take Bimla's value as 100, that's one option to do. Or you can take any other, you can take Amla's value as 100. Any one value you can take 100 and try to solve. Okay, whichever you're comfortable. Right. So if I take Bimla's value is 100. Just taking Bimla's value is 100. Then Amla's value is 20% more, will be 120. Right? So 120. And also income of Amla is 20% less than Kamla. So if it is less than Kamla, so if let's say if Kamla is 100, then Amla will be 80. If Kamla is 100, Amla will be 80. You can make 25% more. So this you can make out. This will be 150 by cross multiplication, whatever. Right? Or you can make 150 ka 20% is 30. You will get 120. 20% is 30. So get this values. So once you get these values, now try to put. Now you just said Kamla's income goes down by 4%. 4% of 150 will be -6, which will give you 144. This is 4% of 150. And Bimla's goes up by 10%, so 110. So how much is the increase? 34 out of 110 is the value. The increase is 34 out of 110. You want, you can directly divide. Okay, 34, 33 is a 1 carry forward 10. So you can make out, 34 divided by 11, 3 is a 33, 1 carry forward 10. So it will be 30.9 something, or 31 will be the answer. Closest. You can approximately divide and get the answer 30.9. So that is the answer. So it's not difficult to calculate. If you just substitute, assume values, it becomes much faster to solve than maybe putting equation. I try to avoid equation. I do put equation wherever required, but most of the questions in the exam don't require. You can actually put up some simple values and easily get the answer. And that is the quickest way to get the answer. Normally in the exam, I'm able to solve all the questions in the examinations. 34 questions from the last 2-3 years, and even before that, purely because I'm able to use the simple substitution techniques and try to get the answer faster. Try it. Once you get used to it, I'm sure you'll be fast. I hope this helps. Thank you.